It's your boy Rah Da God, man. Yo, you tuned in. We got that, man. My boy Shice, man. Stay tuned.
You're not even ready. I ain't even want to show it. Oh, God.
If it's music, you know we got that. Interviews with who, you know we got that. About fashion, hey, you know we got that. The video just dropping, hey, you know we got that. Hey, you know we got that. Shite's the voice of Brooklyn, you know we got that. Hey, you know we got that. Anything you wanna see, baby, we got it.
It's crazy when the world go dark and you can't find the light. When everybody left and you can't make it right. You can see the future clear, but it's out of sight. Out of reach. Gotta push and you gotta fight. Fight against your demons. Fight against your non-believers and underachievers who make them believe that y'all are even. Hard times feel like you're worth less than a dollar even. But if you become more after the odds, then y'all are even. So beat the odds and be the gods that you're praying to. Shit is getting crazy, even predators are praying too. Cops killing niggas or fake crimes that they ain't do. Fuck the police. I hope y'all ain't scared to say it too. I'm on the edge and I'm asking for a push. Life's sour, so I'm asking for the kush. I need a plug. At this point it don't matter, just bring me the drugs. Doing what I can to survive, but they calling me a thug. If that's what I gotta be, fuck hitting the lottery. I'm running up in the closest bank to commit a robbery. In the whip dolly, don't need nobody to rob with me. And I ain't going to jail, these cops gotta body me. Hop out the whip and let it off. Show these motherfuckers how I set it off. I wanna say sorry to all the chicks that I ever really dealt with. Sorry for acting like I never really felt shit. Sorry I never wore my heart on my sleeve. Sorry that I never fought when y'all wanted to leave. But I wasn't trying to feel shit. And it's ironic that I put y'all through the same shit I wasn't trying to deal with. I'm sorry y'all ain't the bitches I still chill with. Said my dick game was bananas, but I peeled quick. Sorry pops, I ain't that ball player that you wanted. And in my whole career I probably only scored 100. I'm sorry I ain't Shaq with it. Sorry you taught me to play ball to keep me out the streets, and I was back in it. Sorry I got that fast money and wasn't stacking it. Moms watched Jerry in the house with no stack in it. Just a pack in it. Sorry my life was all flaws and it ain't good that I ain't got a plaque in it. Sorry I ain't had the time. Sorry you had to wait. Sorry I ain't go to school. Sorry I ain't graduate. By this time I know it's too late. But it's a couple last things that I had to say. Yeah, that I had to say. Couple last things that I had to say.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Shice, the voice of Brooklyn, and you know I'm chilling with my girl, Grace The Stallion.
Doing?
What's going down?
What's going down?
It's about time we made this happen.
It's about damn time we made this happen.
So right now, we in Brooklyn. Yes. We at Extraordinary Sounds, and yo, we about to get lit.
All the way lit, because you know I always got something up my sleeve.
See, I don't know. Me and Grace been trying to get this thing together. We've been trying to work it like where we could be hosts together.
Together.
So we trying to bring Talk It Out, and we got that. Together like a sandwich.
Because
we gonna talk it out. You already know what it is. So, Grace, how was your week?
It was really, really, really rough. It was one of the worst weeks I've ever had in my life.
What you mean?
My dog died on Monday. And my whole family, we took it on the road. I've been crying all week.
Your kids, those are my kids.
Yeah, look, that was my third child.
Third child? You have two children?
I have two boys. Yeah. So it's been a really rough week. It's been rough. And I don't want to talk about it because I'm going to cry. But other than that.
Jimmy, you don't cry. Don't cry, girl. You know Shice got you, girl. Don't you cry, girl.
Shice don't like dogs, okay?
No, I ain't saying I don't like dogs.
That's why I didn't tell you.
I said I don't like other people's dogs. I love dogs. I want a Rottweiler.
Really?
I do. I want a Rottweiler.
My dog was awesome. Oh, he was really awesome.
Yeah. So, what you mean? Like, all right, what made him awesome? I know.
He loved us so much. I could do anything.
Did he like you? Did he like people?
He loves people. Although initially you would not think he does because he'll bark at everything and everybody, but that was him being protective over us. It's like if we're not okay with you, he's not okay with you. But once we okay you, he loves you. He'll be up under you and protect you.
I sound like I would have got my ass beat.
No, my doggy loved everybody.
Oh, what's your dog name? Don't tell me Rock. Rocko.
Guess what it was?
Don't tell me no. Okay, what's the name?
Brooklyn. My doggy's name is Brooklyn. Yeah.
I gotta get back to Brooklyn. My BK. Definitely. Yo, it's just dope. Like, it's been hard. It's been a rough week for me. I've been in and out of the doctor.
You been sick? I tried to check on you, but you had stink when
you
I texted
you.
I text you the next day.
You're
like,
lying.
Did you go to the doctor? And
no.
You gave
no.
me stink answers.
What did I text you back?
Yes, you did.
See, that's
barely.
How I know. That's because I'm a baby when I'm sick.
I was hurt.
Don't play. I'm a baby when I'm sick. I'm like a big ass baby when I'm sick.
No, you gave me stink answers, so I'll
let
you go.
What answer did I give you? What
was stink? You didn't respond
after
a while.
How can somebody be stink through a text? Like, this is the problem that I be having. People trying to get stink in a text. You were like, no, I'm going home.
You gave me
That was shame.
It was, because see how you are now? You're very talkative, and we click, and we talk a lot. But then over time, it's like,
right,
yes, no, okay.
What day was that?
I'm like, Monday, the same day my doggy died.
What day was Monday? Oh, I don't know. I was hurt Monday.
I know, and that's why I checked on you.
No, I was really hurt Monday.
And
no,
you
like,
gave me stink answer.
No, it wasn't a stink answer. That was pissed off. I'm hurt. I want to cry. I want to die and crawl
and
under.
And I said, maybe you should go to a walk-in clinic because you said you were ready for your
You didn't give me that. That didn't
I
say,
did.
I got to show
And you didn't
my phone.
Respond after that.
I don't know. I got to show my phone.
I'm going to blow you out the frame. Okay.
She lying. Everybody on her Facebook,
don't
she
call
lying.
Me a liar.
Listen. So today we got a good show.
Yes.
We got my boy Rah Da God coming through.
Hey! Jokes all day.
The young comedian.
Okay.
Yo, he's hitting the internet hard body. So, you know, now he's going into the next step. He's going to do stand up.
Nice.
Which is dope. That's a hard job.
That's when you really get tested.
So, you know, he's an internet sensation. So now he's getting ready to go comedy. You know what's the best part though?
What?
He's mad young.
He is.
And I was like,
feel the energy though.
When I heard a young guy, I was like, he wanna be a comedian? Like, real? Like, who does that? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what happened? Like, did something happen in his life or something? What happened? He wants to tell jokes on everybody. I'm telling you this, he better not joke on me.
Why not?
If he joke on, because I don't take jokes very well.
Why not? You like to give them.
No. Me and Rah gonna fight. I hope Rah hear me in the studio.
Give him a 60-second roast. Just roast him.
I'll cut the whole station down.
No!
I'll be like this. Your station is old.
You're not much softer than
what
you call me.
Come on, I know you got some topics because you always got something juicy.
Always. You know, I always just want to understand.
Is it one of those like letters? I want one of those letters. That was dope.
You should have told me to bring a letter, man.
Come on, I know you got one offhand. I know you read something. Let's go through it.
He's like, let's go through it.
I'm ready. I want to go through it.
Well, I did have like a question of the day kind of sort of thing. It was kind of like, would you cheat on your significant other if they refused to please you orally? Would you cheat on your significant other?
Well, if your significant other ain't opening the mouth or whatever, you might have to go somewhere. Listen, if you're with your significant other, you're there for a reason. Y'all should be like everything. Like, you should be their nasty thing. Mm-hmm. I should be your nasty thing. We should have that problem.
Hey. So you see how men think differently from women? So like, to you, that's a deal breaker. If a woman is,
I ain't say it was a deal breaker.
Obviously, it is if you're gonna cheat on her.
If she got mad cash, that deal is over. She don't have to do a damn thing.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
So if she has money, it's okay to not give you that.
Absolutely. You got to compensate somewhere.
So you're not going to cheat on her?
With that money? I cheat on myself.
I'm serious. Like, really. Like, so that's not a deal breaker if she has money. But how many girls really got a whole lot of money to take care of you?
I'm not going
to
say it's a deal breaker, but it is upsetting. I don't know. I have to. It
would
depends on how much I love her.
Would you marry her if she don't give you head?
Nah. If we ain't married then, no. If we ain't married now, then no.
So you wouldn't marry a woman?
Absolutely not. No, we got to go in. Marriage is supposed to be through thick and thin, you know, wet and dry, whatever. That's what marriage is about. Everything. You should be doing everything so I didn't have to go to anybody else. That's it.
I agree with you. So, okay. And that goes on both sides, but you know how you have to do double standards. You know, it's okay for the men to get away with that, but the woman can't.
I wear thighs like earmuffs.
So, you're saying you're okay with you giving her a head, it's no problem.
I wear thighs like earmuffs. I'm just saying.
I can't with this dude.
I'm just saying.
But
got my swimsuit, I'm ready to go.
So it's okay for a woman to cheat if her man is not pleasing her orally.
I ain't saying it's good for nobody to cheat because if a woman... See, listen, here you go with this thing.
I'm just saying because you always go for the men and go, yeah, I would cheat. But then when you switch it to the women, held to a different standard. They can't do it.
It's not in your character.
You are crazy right now.
It's not supposed to be in your character.
See, that's why my double standard questions tonight is just for you, Shice. You're the biggest double standard...
I got a question for you.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I got a question.
What?
Can a person fall in love with their side chick or love their side chick more than their main partner?
Absolutely.
Oh, you sound like you're speaking from experience right now.
Absolutely. I absolutely.
Grace, you're nasty.
No. I mean, back in my bad days.
Hey, side dude. You already know.
Back in my bad days when I was younger and didn't care.
Was that yesterday?
No!
I was just asking a question.
It was like 10 years ago.
Just asking a question.
I'm just saying, I dated a married man. And
you nasty little thing.
No, but I didn't know he was married for like the first year. I did not know. I was on my Inspector Gadget thing. Like I had all clues and I was putting my clues together. It took me about a year to figure it out. I figured it out. Because he was good. He was good.
He was doing that theater view.
I had to get my Inspector Gadget on. You know, when women, we have those spidey senses.
So you found out.
I found out.
He was married.
That he was married. But I was in love with him already. So it was kind of hard to leave. And obviously, he wasn't that in love with you.
But did he love you?
Exactly. More than his wife. And that's what we argued about. Because I felt like as long as you had a wife, I wasn't first. And he had to make me realize, everything that we do together, I don't have to do with my own wife. You are first. And it felt like I was, but I'm never first.
Can I ask you a question? Just a question. Don't get mad at me.
What?
Do you think he was just running game?
No.
How do you know that?
So at first, I did.
Listen,
as time went on, I
show you something? Guys will drop down and cry to sell a lie.
No, I don't. And then he divorced her. He did.
And y'all stayed together?
I moved. I left.
What the hell was all of that for?
Because he took too long to do it. I didn't know he was going to really. You know, like you said, I thought he was talking game. So when he kept saying, I'm going to do it, you know, it's not what you think it is.
Grace.
I didn't believe him. He was lying. Because he was already lying.
He did all of that.
So I left.
He did all of that.
Yeah.
He left his wife.
Not
even just left her. He divorced her.
It was his process when I left.
And you dissed him.
I left.
I'd have stalked you.
I did.
I'd be outside your window every day talking about, you won't take me back.
I left.
I'd be saying that song, Jennifer Hudson. Like, you're gonna love me.
But it was a good choice because, you know, if you cheat on your wife, what you gonna do to me?
That's what I'm just, I ain't want to say that.
You can cheat once, you can cheat twice,
I'm
right?
I'm saying. If a girl buy me shoes up front, guess what? This relationship is going no further.
If she buys you shoes.
Yeah.
You're one of those, if you buy a man
pair
of shoes,
you're
going
to
walk out of your life.
Absolutely.
That's some superstition.
You better wait.
That's bull. You know that, right?
You better wait.
That's superstition.
I'm just saying.
Don't try to deflect from the double standards, though. You know that,
okay,
right?
Okay. Yeah, but all right. So let's go back. Now, what are we talking about?
You are the biggest. I don't understand. Since I've known you, you like your double standards, what men can do and women can't do. I don't like that. And I really want your fans to know how big of a sexist you really are.
I'm not a sexist.
Because
I'm
you
sexy.
Are.
I'm not a sexist. You know, you gotta get that together.
You always going for the men, and you're not fair to the women.
Oh, hello. What team do I play for?
It doesn't matter. Let's hello. Be real. Look at Steve team Harvey. Man. He's a man, but he keeps it real. He tells the women
his
to
his mustache clouds his judgment, okay? With not. That bush, it clouds his judgment. I don't care what nobody say. He can't see behind the bush. Okay, that's it.
Okay, double standard number one.
Okay.
Age. Why is it always okay for a woman?
Oh, we got a phone call.
Oh my gosh. Marvin, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Hold on, let's see. Let's see. Hold on.
Who's calling?
Yo, that's Mike G. Mike G, what up?
Yeah, I'm the other man.
What?
What she walked out on. Baby, come back, baby.
Yo, do you really got like this? Do you got this? I don't know what this sexy voice you're trying to put
he
on,
said
but
I'm the other man.
You need to send it back to the store.
Hey, daddy.
Baby, I'm the man.
Hey, daddy.
You know what?
You should have never let me go.
You on the craziest
shit I've ever heard right now, Mike. Well, I don't know what's going on.
Why are you hating?
Shy, she left in the middle of the night. I went to work, I came back the next day. All her stuff was moved out.
Yo,
he took too long to divorce his wife.
I don't know what's up with Mike G. Mike G is crazy. He's just strange like that.
I'm going back to divorce counseling. I have to go. Goodbye.
Yo, peace out, Mike.
Mike,
if y'all don't
hilarious.
Know, that's Mike G. He runs the station. Listen, let me tell you about Mike G. And I know he's still listening. You never trust a man with a mustache like his.
I have men with mustache.
No. I ain't say with mustache. I said with a mustache like his. He got like the only rapist mustache.
Oh my God.
Like, you can't trust him with his mustache. You gotta look at his mustache. I'm telling you.
Why?
Huh? It's just a weird looking mustache.
Like a Sherlock
yo,
Holmes.
Yo, we get on him all the time. I know he listens to
like. Like a Sherlock Holmes mustache.
Nah, it ain't a Sherlock Holmes mustache. This is a don't put your face hit mustache.
It's not one of those you can go down
there. Nah, shout out to the boy, Mike G.
Mike G.
Mike G gonna kill me later.
I can't with you.
He gonna be like this, yo, call me later. Oh, man.
They keep saving you from your double standard.
Okay, let's go back. I'm sorry.
Age is my question. Why, when a man dates a younger woman, he's a player, man of the year.
Facts.
When a woman dates a younger man,
she's
a cougar. She's lonely. She's desperate.
She is.
Explain. You see? You see what I'm saying, guys?
Hold you guys.
You see?
All right. First of all, we know as men we are nasty. We know as men we just trying to keep our groove there. Y'all are too emotional. Uh-oh. That must be my
G. Uh-oh. Mike, you better have an answer to this question while you come
hold
here
on.
Interrupting this answer. Because he keeps getting away with it.
See, Mike G's calling back. Go ahead, Mike.
I warned you about talking about my mustache.
Hey, Mike, you can't do that right now. Oh, he hung up.
Oh, shoot. He banged it on you. Good job, Mike. Good
That's not funny. Because if I suspend the day, guess what? Then we don't have a conversation.
No, Mike likes me. Oh, man, he just said I broke his heart.
You see, you walked out on him, so we both suspended right now.
You know, the good thing about that is I can always go back. Yeah.
You want that old thing back?
Oh, I'm never an old thing. Oh. I'm always the right thing, the tight thing. Boy, don't get me started. I am never the old thing. Don't
say that. Say the tight thing?
I said the right thing. Yes.
Yeah, you mean the tight thing.
Okay,
let's go. So what about this double standard?
Age. You keep getting off that.
It's not me. I swear it's not me.
No more interruptions unless y'all got some answers for this question.
I'm waiting to see. The age thing, what was so wrong with me?
Age, what, double standard,
uh-huh.
King of double standard.
I am.
You
I'm
really are, and I just want to buy
it's
yourself.
Not, it's the rules, that's it. The rules apply, that's it.
Who told you those rules? Tell me a rule book where you see that there's a rule.
Sometimes it's rules that are unwritten, but you have to follow.
It's not a rule back. Listen, there was a movie made about how it
you go to the hood, you don't snitch. It's not written, but you know that you don't snitch.
That's totally different.
No, it's not.
Snitching goes for both sexes, men and women. It's bad on both. This does not apply to both. Why is it okay for a man to date younger women, no matter how young he is, player of the year?
Because them young girls know how to do that thing that them old men like. That's all I'm saying.
And you think young men don't know how to do the same for older women?
Nah, y'all just dealing with somebody stupid.
OMG.
Right. You just looking for another son. You looking for a Joey. You looking for a baby boy.
How about so many women that date older men and they're worse than dating younger men? They're stupid.
No, they just like, yo, thanks. Listen, them young girls, they titties is perky. You know, everything
oh
just sitting right is fresh.
You are hot.
You wasn't even supposed to be talking about this, right?
Yes, we are. You see? I want your viewers and your listeners to see how big of a
take
joke.
A picture. Write it down. I don't give a... Just do it. You know what? Let's take a break. So, you know, we'll be back right after this. All right.
No, dude, like, I was, like, actually, like, not even... Oh, God. Tim. 07? College days. Yeah. This is our song. Let it marinate. Yeah, this is us. Okay, yeah. We like totally have to do our dance that we did in college, remember? Frat parties? Yeah. Oh God, Sarah, remember? Come on. Okay. The fist pump is coming up. Huh? All right. Still the 410? Uh-huh. Oh, you dog, I swear. We're going for a job. Going for a job. Oh yeah. Killer. Dude, we're like in love with the song. You guys are too? Where are you guys from? Massachusetts. Oh wow. No, we're Jersey boys. Yeah, upper west side. So what do you guys do for like a living or whatever? Retail? Are you kidding me? Dude, that's amazing. No, we're like more to like stocking than like stocks, prices, and things like that. Yeah, we should like definitely go back to the bar and get a couple drinks. Alright? Let's get one. This song kills me.
Yo, anybody, y'all give me your vibes. Right, I know the khaki redder than a brake light. Move off, rough it up and tough it up with all my might. And that'll make you come quicker than the speed of light. You make the little generalize up to a massive height. Sweet juice for the belly, this a cane of blight. In a bush, girl, remember me a the Tina type. Me a the Tina type. Girl, bring your back, make me sight up the treasure. Fuck long like a flight to a major. Sex on my job, work on my ledger. Real bad man, now go bike for the pleasure. Hey, cocky block like when February come. Pussy pinker than breast cancer month. She say me bad like say me can't done. You never know, say me full up of the testosterone. Hey,
can me love off your vibes. Call me in the middle of the night. Can you know me have the style where you like. Me a send kid deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly, girl. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly, girl.
Alright, take it off, make the sicker than apply. Beat it up without no pity, I'll make you want cry. Hardiness, I take your body from the day your sight high. Me not lie, you deal with the cock like a damn pie. Blows, pants, all of that we pop off. Real stiff cock in a your hole and I no knock off. Hold on, what you say you want to take the top off. Put it to your head and make you frost and all the mud off.
Jam a love off your vibes. Call me in the middle of the night. Can you know me have the style where you like. Me a send kid deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly, girl. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Whoa. In a run, don't get like my queen. When it come to woman, we a top king. From woman in no switch. Tell them all with them national dish. We change girl like Chuck Gear. Say she coulda catch me but I said not there. It no matter. Me, I tell you sorry if me did give you a bun. Can me love off your vibes. Call me in the middle of the night. Can you know me up this time of your life. Me, I send kid deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly, girl. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly. Deep in your belly, girl.
Y'all, it's your boy Shice, the voice of Brooklyn. My girl,
Grace the Stallion in the building.
Right now, we have the young God.
What's good?
Rah the God. What's up?
Hey.
What's good, man?
Oh, here he go. He gonna be on his old smooth. Listen.
I know the ladies is watching. That's all I know.
Listen. Okay, they watching it. What? So you gotta be smooth?
Nah, I'm a little bit of everything today.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, you feel me?
I know that's right.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, she know.
So Rah, right now you are like the internet sensation. What's going down?
Oh man, like it's just love. Like that's the main reason why I do this, man. Like it's just like people give me love, and that's just gonna keep pushing. That's why I do it, man. Like I know you're gonna live, so why not do it?
So for those who don't know, Rah Da God, how old are you?
17.
17.
Wow.
Crazy. I know.
Uh-oh. 17 years old.
Get out of here.
He's been doing all types of skits. Like if you look. Yo, your boy is on here. Yo, he does this, the white boy thing kills me all the time.
No, please, don't get me started. Don't get me started. I just asked you something.
Okay. Is that something you go through? Like, because you're a comedian, people just like walk up to you and go say something funny.
I mean, like, you know what? Like, that's crazy. That's a good question. Like, I hate that so much.
I knew it. I
hate that so much. Like, if I'm doing something, don't just come out of nowhere. Like, oh. Honey, that's the funny man. Can you do something funny? Like, no, I'm not your monkey. Like, yeah. I'm not gonna just sit here and perform.
Put a quarter in me. Like,
yeah, like, nah, man. Like, yo, like, just let it come naturally. Like,
he just said, I'm not your monkey.
Yeah, like, I hate that so much, man.
So do something funny.
Look, you know, I'm not even about to look his way. That's what he wants. You want to
be saying.
Look, yeah. That's what I'm doing.
You know, yo, listen, the circus is in town. You can go ahead and go for it. I'm just saying.
They closing down, honey.
They going to Mount Vernon next.
It's a wrap after this.
Yo, it's killing.
They leaving. Yeah, the circus is going out of business.
Oh.
This is their last year.
Yeah, that's the wrap. They don't got no monkeys.
They're not getting any money.
Don't worry. Call Rah Da God.
Yeah.
They're not being sued, and they're not making money.
Wow.
In my line, I got y'all. Don't worry about it.
You know, animal rights people don't play.
Yeah,
you know
they're
right.
Out there going,
no more. No more monkeys. No more. Save our monkeys.
Yes.
Come on.
Save
you guys
monkeys.
Are really killing me.
They're not here for our entertainment. Monkeys are people, too.
Care about yourselves, man. That's it. People only care about themselves.
Truth.
Yo, you do sound like
that's how you sound. That's how every person sounds right there, front row.
So let me ask you, why comedy? Like, what made you say, yo, I want to make people laugh?
You know what? It was when I was younger, like, I think it was the first time I ever stepped in a classroom. Like, I just had that, like, I just could make anybody laugh. And it's just like all my years through school, like, I changed schools a lot. It just changed.
Uh-oh, you sound like a trouble kid.
Yeah.
He said, I changed schools a lot.
Nah,
I get kicked out. They be like, honey, get that hair out of here.
He's got to go.
No, he's so judgmental. I moved around a lot.
He could have been a military kid.
Exactly.
He's not smart.
Exactly.
You know
he's killing me. Look.
He moved around from foster kid to foster home to foster home. Honey, well, this monkey can't stay here,
honey. Have you seen the new kid? I don't think he's troubled.
See?
He doesn't belong here. No, he doesn't.
I just changed schools. Like, my mom moved a lot, and it was just like, that's what we had to do. Like, you feel me?
She was getting fired?
No, you bad. She getting fired?
I moved a lot.
You get fired. I know.
I'm not doing this, man.
The people want to know the raw truth.
I'm trying to be as honest as possible. Look, they look.
So you was a bad kid?
No. You're like lucky black. He probably did something. He got charged.
No. I'm a military kid.
I am a good kid. It's just sometimes teachers piss me off. That's it. Like
you didn't become a comedian because you flunked high school.
No, exactly. She know.
He's on the verge to a GED, so he said I might as well use it and go make dumb people laugh.
Yo, this is what it is.
He's supposed to be roasting you. He's trying to roast you.
I'm not roasting him, but I'm just saying. Listen.
He's good at deflecting.
He's 17 years old. What 17-year-old, you know, goes, you know what? I'm going to be a comedian.
Funny ones.
No, that means I ain't got shit to do. I ain't got nothing else.
I'm different.
Thank you.
Hello. Look, Future said it best. I'm different. No. It was Two Chainz. I'm different.
You don't follow the pattern.
Exactly. I don't. Look, I know I'm different. And I was like, you know what? This is really, this is the main reason why I chose comedy. Is because, like, I feel like every black dude want to be a basketball player.
Exactly.
A football player.
Yeah, it makes millions.
You know what? You're right. You're
yeah,
right.
You know, my comedy,
do too. Comedy do too. I play basketball. You. I love basketball. There's nothing wrong with it. Like, I love it. Right. I want to do something different. Why
don't,
can't I
don't,
be different?
Don't brag about that. I saw your game.
Oh.
You know.
Oh. All right.
I'm not even about to bring that in there.
Let's
I'm not about to bring that in.
Listen,
there.
Listen, like, he did one thing, right? I thought it was nice. He spent it on his fingers, and I was like this. I said, oh, he's spinning it on his face. That's dope, right? Yeah. Then you see the game, you're like, oh, he's on a bench.
Nah, nothing. Look, he's playing with me. No, no.
You gonna let him do you like that?
I'm not even about to get on that level. He hating. That's what I let him do. Yeah. I feed off that type of energy.
Thank you.
I'm feeding off of it. That's all
right. So let me ask you this. Real jokes. No jokes. How do you deal with hecklers? Like, people that you making jokes at, and then they try to take over your show.
Like you just
okay.
did.
Yeah, I love
it. How did I do that? Yeah. Actually, wait. No. This is my show. But it's our show. It's
his moment.
You know what I do? I give him a chance. Like, no, go ahead. Don't laugh.
What do you think he's going to do?
Some corny. He's always something corny back to me. And I just look at him like, you try. Like, right? Like, at least you try. You know, just walk away. That's the best thing you can do. Because I always kill them. It's just like, I'm not about to do this, man. Like, they always try to, like, come back and switch it around on me. It never works. Like, so, I already got the crowd. It never works.
So, did you do, like, the lunchroom thing? Like,
that was my thing.
Everybody come around in the circle. You know, like, we used to do that in school.
That's how you did it.
That was the show right there. That was my time to shine. Every time during lunch, like, I always had, like, you know, whatever table I was sitting at, it was always like every single film.
See, I told you. That's why you got kicked out.
That's how you got out.
I told you. That's where I was going with it.
But you wasn't the class clown in the classroom.
Absolutely, he was.
Disrupting
was.
The teacher.
I was.
That's why he was changing school.
Thank you. Now everybody knows why he moved the line. He got kicked out.
You was a class clown.
It's not me. It's the people around me.
It's the people.
Okay, well, let me ask you this question. Did you make the teacher laugh?
Course.
Oh, see, he's in there. He's in there. He
you know if you make the teacher laugh.
You know why? You make the teacher laugh. You good.
Excuse me.
You know that.
Can I tell you why the teacher laugh? Because when she kicked his ass out, she was like, look at that monkey go. He's got to go. That monkey's got to go.
Yeah, you know what? And then she will always.
He's out of here.
They will always love pulling me out of the classroom and have a little individual conversation.
See?
Right. The joke is,
yes.
He's going to tell the joke. The students will laugh.
Exactly.
They're going to see his grade, and then they go laughing in.
Exactly.
He got a big F.
You know,
and it wasn't for fun.
Did you ever crack on the teachers?
Yeah,
see, that's the problem.
That's why you got kicked out.
No, really, not in class.
That's why his mom's is getting fired.
You know, that's why.
Not in class.
It is what
it is.
I'm trying to ride with you.
Not
man.
In class. He's killing me. Like, he's making it seem like I am just trouble.
Yes.
No, I'm a good kid. Look, teachers know I was a good kid. It's just, I can't stop talking. That's the thing. I cannot stop talking, no matter if I'm in the classroom. No matter where I'm at, I just can't stop talking. You just have to respect that. That's all it was.
Okay,
that's
tell great. Us about a moment where you like bombed when you were performing.
Oh, okay.
And you just
I'm
bombed.
Waiting for this. Let's go.
You know what? That's crazy. All right. Sorry.
Today. Sorry.
He's so evil.
Sorry, go for it.
I had this performance.
Come on.
I'm not going to do this. Let me know when you're done.
Exactly.
All right, come on. We're live. Come on. Let's go. We're live.
Man, look. All right, so I had this one performance. You know, I'm just so prepared. Like, I think I'm about to kill it. Everything's going good. You feel me? So I get on stage, and I'm like, all right, I had said some joke about the last comedian that came on stage.
Yeah. Bad move.
Yeah, that was the worst thing I could have ever did. I'm like, oh, that wasn't him talking. That was drugs talking. One person laughed. Like, they all looked at me like, what the hell are you talking about? And And I tried to transition into another joke. Just like, all right, let me get their minds off that. And they just wasn't feeling it. Like, they was like,
so
all right.
So how do you pick up after?
Yeah.
This is exactly what I did. I'm like, you know what? Let me just be real with myself. And I just switched. I'm like, all right, y'all not laughing. And y'all looking at me like, what the hell is this kid talking about? And they're just dying. And I'm like, yo, like, y'all killing me. Like, he looking at me like, what? Like, he about to slap me. And then another man was looking like, you know, he wanted to throw something at me. He looked like he had a fresh tomato just ready to launch it at me. And I was just like, yo, I'm not doing this, man. And I was just like, yo, I gotta get off the stage.
Let me ask you this. I always gotta ask, especially with comedians,
yeah.
What is your most embarrassing moment ever?
Okay. Most embarrassing. Got you.
You met me?
Yeah. Yeah, that's why I did that. No. All right, so I was in ninth grade. I'll never forget this. And I had just came from a basketball game. It was like in the Brooklyn, Bronx, I don't remember, but I remember I was on the train headed home, and I had to pee so bad.
Oh, I forgot we were live. I forgot. I'm sorry. We're live.
I didn't want to say it. Hey,
he was really enjoying the show too. He was like, look at this. Look, young excellence. That's what it is. But look, that's what he was looking like.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, so look, I'm not about to do this. I'm not doing this, man. Yo,
hold on, let's put all those in the studio. All right, for those on the radio, y'all didn't understand. Somebody walked by, and it was like,
that nigga smelled like tuna fish and
ass. For real, yeah, I thought somebody took off their shoes.
I was looking, I was like this.
Yeah. Oh, he back. We should never see that number.
Oh, God.
What you mean?
Let's go.
I need y'all to call in. 347-960-3486.
Come on,
man. Talk to me.
Talk to me. We gotta
take a break
and come back with Ronnie God. Because, yo, we gotta come back with Ronnie God. Hold on a second. Let's go.
A quick break.
We'll be back.
The stitch is coming.
Dog in my city, they overlooking me over the frauds in my city. No autumn, they wanna see me fall in my city. From the trenches, it ain't pretty at all in my city. I grew up a good kid with a good family, but in my hood, I had some bad influences around me. All the negativity sucked me up like a thotty. I used to go to sleep hearing gunshots from a shotty. So waking up at school, I was never feeling jolly. I always had it in my head, I could be the next body. On my way to school, drug dealers in my lobby. I ran away, nobody had a job like Tommy. Yeah, they were surviving, no for public assistance. And I was fortunate getting everything on my wish list. I never had to struggle, but the struggle's what I witnessed. That's why they looking down on me, but I ain't a midget. And it's crazy how when you doing good, they call you corny. They'd rather see you behind bars, dead on Maury. And when you got some good news, they calling you annoying. But when he doing good, it be a whole nother story. And it's funny how your man's a change over the clout and the fame. But money holds and chains to make anybody change. It be the same picture, just another frame. New players, the same game. I'm in the stoop, like cigarettes and Project Core ways. I'm sick with it, spending all day. I keep a migraine. I'm the best in this underground scene. I go from Brooklyn to city to BX like the 4-5 train. I'm underrated, that's why I'm always doing my thing. They sending shots cause I ain't feeling them like Luke Cage. I got bigger problems from tired of walking around with change. I'm working for a better life and not just better days. Sunshine, but it's a full-time rain with me. Ain't no half-stepping like Big Daddy Kane with me. I'm a warrior, they never come out to play with me. I'm headed to the banks like G-Unit Bang with me. Everybody wanna charge for a feature like they made it, but they mediocre. I'm just being honest, I ain't hating. I put my city on my back like Zab Judah, but when Ray Leavis going down like the Baltimore Ravens, it's Ravage.
We are back with Rah the God. So, yo, y'all missed it. Grace was in here spraying, like physically spraying, like she sprayed everything.
I'm a woman.
Can I be honest for a minute though? Rah, I was praying that it was not you, man. Man, yo, when that phone came, we was all looking at each other like, I don't know. This, I was looking at feet like, did he take the shoes off?
Like, who took the shoes?
Then I looked over, I said, well, she already got sandals, so it ain't her.
But Shice don't know. In my head, I'm like, it's this nigga. I know it's him. I'm not tripping. But I'm not going to speak on that, though. But
as long as y'all didn't think
it was me. Yeah, I was like,
I don't know, because, you know, we were talking about a lot. And, you know, I was praying that it wasn't you, because I was going to go with him first. You know, I was going to give you the benefit of the doubt. I was like, you know, Lord, please don't let it be Grace. It is so ungodly for a woman to smell like that.
Yes.
It wasn't, I knew it wasn't loud.
It was loud.
She looked like she take her house.
Thank you. I love him.
Those be the ones that be smart. Yo,
say
that again. Hello. You don't know.
Listen, I know people who put
like that. You better ask.
So just like flowering roses.
Thank you. So much, man. I get
to. Hallelujah.
Hello.
Did I just tell you this boy young? Did I tell you the boy
he's 17?
No, exactly.
Oh, so this is the topic we were talking about.
You know what?
Look. Oh, okay, cougar. Okay. I see.
Oh, now I'm a cougar.
I see. That's what we doing. We doing the cougar thing.
I like to train them.
I just told
that's
you.
The Bible said, right?
She trying to be a basketball wife. Little did he know he a bench warmer.
Nah.
The
lineup. My
That's how you do, girl.
Yo, on. I'm saying. So who writes your material? Like, I've been watching you, following you on Instagram now, and I see your clips. Who comes up with your material?
The one and only, man. Like,
Rah Da God?
Yeah, Rah Da God, man.
No, Jesus.
Right.
No, Rah Da God.
It better come from your dirt.
He's not in my Bible.
Listen, we made up a whole nother Bible. You need to go check that out. But that's why I write that funny in that Bible. Right.
When you how you know what you're writing is funny? Okay. Who tells you that it's funny?
This is what I do. Like, first, like, I write it down, whatever. I do the video, I do the skit, and I send it to specific people, like close friends. They gonna let me know.
You got a team.
Yeah, like, they gonna let me know if it's funny or not.
But are they honest?
I was just about to go there. Listen, do you have yes men? Because I hate a yes man.
Exactly.
Me too.
That's right. You like, yo, that's hot. So yes, if you get out there performing, they like,
I hate it to death. I got people that's gonna tell me, look, it's funny, but it's not that funny.
So let me ask you this. Do you think you're funny?
Do you think I'm funny?
No.
Oh, shoot.
Do you think I'm funny?
I think you're
funny. Well, damn it, I'm funny then. That's it.
I'm not
worried about you. That's what it is. You hate it. I know it's up. Hey, thank you.
And
you
did.
Shice, you hate it, man. Yo, you really have, you know, young nigga doing good. You feel me? Like, I'm shining right now.
Because he likes skin.
Exactly.
You
have to eat this morning. That's what it was.
I'm light skin. Yeah, you know how it is. Look. Bringing chocolate back.
Oh, exactly. So the dark skin people just go team up on
that's all it is. But you acting like one of the white men. That's what you're acting. I mean, he's funny, but he
put him over there in a truck.
Exactly.
Hold on. I gotta speak in your terms. He's funny, but it's not like he's funny funny. You know, black people always switch stuff and they think if they say it three times, exactly, it's funny. It's not like it's hot, but it's hot.
I mean, that's like, all right, but you can make it a little better, though, you know what I mean? Sound like a hater. I'm not doing this. Mad Deshaun.
Hate. A lot of hate from the
exactly
right room.
Only Deshaun.
I'm not even hating.
You shice.
I just got a job at McDonald's. Like, I'm good. I'm not hating on you.
Yo, let me ask you this. Because you are funny. Let me say that. Let me put that out there for real. He is funny. Who is your favorite comedian? Like, who are your influences?
Oh, man. Most people would think I would say Kevin Hart, but honestly, it's Ari Spears, man. I don't know if you know this dude.
Yo, Spears is funny.
He's a killer. Like, the way his accents, the way he knows.
He can switch it.
Yo, it's amazing, yo. Like, I really
wow, I didn't believe that you would say that, though. Exactly. I'm going to be honest. I bypassed him.
I know. People wouldn't even expect
that. I didn't even think that.
Yo, that's like the first comedian I ever watched, and it was like I went straight into laughing. Like the first joke he said to the last joke, it was like, yo, this dude is ill, man.
Yo, he's definitely funny.
He's ill, yo.
Yo, Grace always got these games,
oh,
right?
God. Oh, God. I love
Grace.
I do.
Go ahead.
You know, I like to play with all my artists. Kind of like test.
Wait, time out. Pause.
Yeah, no.
Pause. You like to play with your artists?
I like
what? You do know his mom's
you
just
don't
here, right?
Enough.
I can't do.
I'm still calling 911 after the show.
She gonna jack me up, right?
Grace is going in on a paddy wagon. She said, I like to play with my artists.
You know what I mean. We like to play games.
We all know what you mean.
You know. I like to just test your knowledge and, you know, tease just to see where your head is at. So it's called Keep or Kill, okay?
Keep or Kill.
What we do is you get two comedians. You're gonna tell me which one you're keeping and which one you're killing. You can only keep one out of the two.
Okay,
are you ready?
Let's do it.
All right, so our first keep or kill, we got Jamie Foxx or Martin.
Oh, God.
Which one would you keep? He said easy.
Oh, who you gonna
keep? Keeping Martin. That's like.
Wow, you're
with him.
I'm sorry, I can't.
I love Jamie, but Martin is on a whole nother level.
I say that too.
Whole nother level.
And you know what? The tattoo on the back of Jamie Foxx's head kills me. It bugs me out. I cannot watch him.
Are you serious? Jamie Foxx is hilarious.
He is.
Hilarious.
But now he's more of a serious guy.
If he's hilarious, then what's Martin?
Hey, Martin is hilarious
too. Thank you, times two.
But Jamie's more talented. Jamie, come on now.
We're talking about comedy.
But since they're both on the same level of comedy to me.
No.
You gotta look for some.
So who's show is better?
Martin or Jamie Foxx?
Martin's show was better.
All right, there you go. Seals the deal.
But that doesn't mean Jamie Foxx wasn't funny.
First of all, you said, just like a woman, she said he sings. He's not singing to us.
I can't pick between Jamie and Martin. I love them both. Like,
you have to pick one. Don't you have to. Who gets the goddamn axe?
Let's go.
three.
The owner of the chain. I don't have to
one.
Pick.
You have to pick. Let's go.
I have to go with Jamie.
Oh my
God. Kill her.
I love Jamie Foxx. Nah.
Security. Yeah, she's gone. I knew she was gonna mess up.
Oh, now he turned his back on me.
Yo, she was doing so good. So good. I love her.
I love
then she
Jamie.
Said the chain.
I love Martin too. I can't choose. I'm sorry. That's
no,
just too
you said you already choose. You
okay,
killed Martin.
Okay, moving on.
Let's go.
Eddie Murphy or Chris Rock?
Oh, man.
Eddie Murphy.
This is actually hard.
Eddie Murphy. Or Chris
I'm
Rock?
I'm keeping Eddie.
You keeping Eddie?
Eddie Murphy.
Who you keeping?
I'm going to say Chris Rock, man.
What?
Wow.
Only because growing up, I watched everybody hates Chris.
You know,
and that show
I love
was
that show.
Exactly.
Here's the thing. You know what it is? This is when his young mind comes
into
play.
I love
that because Eddie hasn't done stand-up in a long time.
Is,
so he probably was
good. And I never watched his stand-up.
Listen.
Eddie Murphy's a classic.
Come on. Eddie Murphy had that thing on Raw, and he was like this at the movie theater. He was like this. He was like, hey. I'm standing in front of the movie theater, the Italian guy, when he's like, hey, I want some choo-choo beans and some bonbons, and a nigga here's gonna pay for it. That had me in tears. When he did the gay guy on top of the car doing the sirens, he's like, woo! Pull over.
Oh, my God!
You gotta watch Raw, and you gotta watch the
Rock. I didn't like Chris until I got older because Chris Rock is a serious comedian. Like, so when I say serious, I mean he jokes about real stuff. But it's funny, but it's the truth.
It's not funny unless you don't know what he talks about.
He's like
about.
A political comedian.
Right. And
you have to understand what's going on. So when I was younger, I wasn't really into Chris Rock, but now that I'm older, I love Rock.
I think one of the funniest things that Chris Rock said was about money. He said, if Bill Gates had Oprah's money, he'll kill himself because he think he was broke. You know what I'm saying?
That's
like,
true.
And he said, here I am thinking I'm rich, but I live next door to a dentist.
Exactly.
That was serious. I was like, wow.
Yeah,
that's
he
so
true.
That's
stuff.
Crazy because I'm just not thinking like, damn, the
right.
dentist is looking like.
Chris Rock taught me that every man is trying to get someone he meets you. He's like, ladies, when a man walks up to you, this is exactly what he's saying. When he says, hi, my name is, what he really saying, translation,
that's true, though.
What color is your hair? Translation, can would you like to go out to dinner? Translation, can I was like, you know what, Chris?
That's a fact.
I love
that.
He's absolutely right on everything that he said.
Don't do that like that.
But you didn't need Chris Rock for that. I could have told you that.
Oh, wow.
I don't know like this. It's
great to hear a man say the crap that men
first of all, exactly. We don't approach no women unless we think they're attractive.
Exactly.
We never go to an ugly person just to have conversations.
Nope.
So you wouldn't be friends with a female that you're attracted to just to be friends with her?
I'll do that. I can do that.
No.
Hold
on.
So I'm not doing it right
now. Let's keep it real, though. Let's keep it real. You look first.
Yep.
And then you decide. Once you realize that you don't have a chance, then you put it in the friend's home.
Oh,
right.
Wow.
That's how it works.
That's how it works.
Yeah.
So if you got a chance, you're going for it.
Yeah.
If you think you got a
little
no matter what the situation is.
If you told this man right now he could get some,
wow.
If you told him right now he could get some, guess what? That friend zone is out.
It's over.
Wow.
It's
going
over.
I'm going in for the
channel.
It's just, that's just logic, man. That's just dude.
See how men think? I just think that's
but
logic.
Like, yo, like.
I just
want
to get all into y'all brain.
You know what? You're right. But you know what? To be honest, I don't know if it's because I'm young, but when I'm talking to a female, I'd be straight up, right from jump. If I want to just do that, then I'm like,
he'd be like, hey,
that's all I want to do.
Mm.
I want to do that. Or if I want to,
you
know, I'll tell her, yeah.
That's that new age, though.
Mm.
That's the new way.
Right, that's it.
I'd rather you be straight up.
Exactly.
I'd rather be
lying.
Like, boy, bye.
Exactly.
Then to sit there and fall in love, and then you play me.
See, there you go. See?
Shut up.
I'd be like this. Hey, those thighs are really looking good. Can I put some chocolate on?
That's
what she walk away.
Thank you.
Pow, pow, pow. She's
going to
look at you. Who are you?
Pow,
pow. Bye. Look,
she'll be like this. She'll be like, who are you again? That's how that usually works.
Anyway,
who are you?
Back to Kill.
No,
all right. Number three. Ooh, this is kind of a hard one. Red Fox or Richard Pryor?
Oh,
woo! Red Fox or
first
Richard
of all, young boy, do you even know who
that
is?
I know,
are?
Right?
Of course.
You better know.
I know he was looking at me like that. Like, you don't even know.
He keeps trying to crack
me
in the
game. That's why I'm not talking to you about it.
Thank you.
You the one that came up with the game. He not even talking about it.
You know what I'm saying?
Some boys, I got to tell
you. Red Fox,
I gotta get
Richard Pryor.
Richard Pryor, hands down.
Wow. I gotta go with Richard on that.
I'm gonna go with Richard.
And hey, we finally agree, ding, ding, ding.
Finally, you know,
gotta
that's
do a booty
that's
dance
a
for that, Chase.
Look, he know how to do it to perfect. Hold on, Chase. I got this show, matter of fact.
Called him out.
Look, late night, male stripper, child under.
Shice, should be twerking.
I don't twerk, I sling that thing.
Hey!
Let's get it straight.
Shice be twerking.
I don't twerk, I sling. That's not a bad.
That's it.
Hands down. I'd be like this if I'm putting it on your head, am I on your
mind? I was Shice.
Just like
that. All right. Number four. You better get this one right or you're going to be, ooh. Kevin Hart. I'm going to just stop right there.
That's it.
No, I can't because it's the hardest one. Kevin Hart or Bernie Mac?
Oh.
Yeah, I just burped it, right?
I would give it Bernie Mac.
I can't choose.
I can't choose.
There's no way.
No, you have to give it to Bernie Mac.
I can't.
You have to go with the legend.
You got
it. Listen, he put the blueprint.
If you want to throw that,
because you know what? There probably would be no Kevin Hart.
Without a Bernie Mac. I got to give you that.
Exactly. I got to
give
Bernie Mac.
Young Buck.
Everybody know him downstairs.
Bernie Mac?
I got to go with Bernie Mac.
He's like, I was scared of you. He said, I put my shit on his home.
I was like, yes.
I love Bernie Mac. He's a classic. Rest in peace. He's funny. I would choose Bernie over anybody. That's right. Fun too.
If you don't go, no disrespect. We're not disrespecting Kevin Hart. Disrespect to him. But you gotta go with the legend. You have to.
Bernie, all day. All right. Steve Harvey or Bill Cosby?
Oh. I'm going with Bill Cosby.
Oh, Lord.
Because he goes for the pudding.
He goes for the pudding.
I'm going with Bill.
Over Steve
Harvey. I'm going to have to go with Steve because he be putting the women on. Yeah. Bill was accused of getting on the women.
Listen.
Okay?
No, it's how you look at it.
Nah.
He was like, come on, baby. He's like, come get the pudding.
Yo, them girls know they was getting themselves into, man. Come on, messing with Bill, he gonna make you laugh. Then he gonna slip it in the drink while you're not watching because your eyes is closed all the time while you're laughing.
See?
By the time you take the drink. By the time you take the drink, you like, hold up. You just hearing all type of noise.
That's why I respect Rah Da God. Because Rah Da God is even saying himself that he would have let Bill fuck him. Look at that.
I'm not rolling that way.
Is that what you just said?
I'm not rolling that way, man. As a former comedian, I know. I'm not.
You said a former comedian? Listen, you quit?
No.
You quit today?
Get you.
Only cause Shice is over here killing
horrible.
Me, man. He's killing me. He pointing out all my disappointments right now, man. I'm losing all the fans.
Yo, Shice, I can't.
Oh,
sorry, go ahead.
Bill Cosby wins that one. I can't with y'all over here. All right, I got another one. My man, Cat Williams or Dave Chappelle?
Cat. No, hold on.
Cat Williams, Dave Chappelle.
Damn, they both was high.
They both was high.
They both was drugged up.
I'm going.
Yeah.
He said, I'm going with.
I can tell you who I'm choosing.
Cat, who you going?
Cat Williams.
Cat, I gotta go with Cat.
I never found Dave Chappelle funny.
Chappelle
show, I never got into
first of all,
the Chappelle show.
Dave Chappelle brought back. Who can bring back an R&B artist who's been out of the scene for years? He brought back Rick James.
That's true.
He put him back to life.
That's true.
Okay.
Did you ever see the skit he did with Prince? Did you see that?
Yeah,
That was hilarious. And he played basketball in that damn top and then said,
you want some pancakes?
Yo, that wasn't funny.
Dave Chappelle just doesn't do it for me.
Tyrone Biggles would smoke rocks, bitch. No. Come on.
She's killing me. I gotta go with Cat, though. I'm not gonna lie to you. Cat is different.
I love Cat.
What year?
His brunch is different.
Funny.
That's it.
He's different.
Gut wrenching funny.
Yeah,
I love Cat.
I like Cat, though. I do. But
shout out to Cat on that one. Yeah. Bam. All right, my last one. Chris Tucker or Mike Epps?
Yo, these are so good.
Yeah. Chris Tucker. You know what's funny about them together? Because I don't think either of them are funny on stand-up. I think they're funny in movies. They're not funny on stand-up to me.
They tell one good joke per stand-up.
Yes, but in movies, I'd be in stitches.
I would give it to Chris Tucker, though.
Chris Tucker.
I definitely
would. And they're the same.
I think I would give it to Mike Epps. He be having me in more tears.
You just get,
Chris got all a little uppity
on us and got a little ditty. Right. You know what I mean?
That was before, though. But if you go back to Def Jam days, yo.
Oh, you said Michael Jackson?
Yeah, Def Jam.
What you said about Michael Jackson?
Right.
Michael Epps?
Chris Tucker, back in Def Jam, he said something about Michael. He said if Michael Jackson was a pimp.
Right.
I was dying. Man.
But even my ex had a good Michael Jackson joke too. He was like, Michael Jackson be walking around with giraffes in a hood while niggas walking around with pit bulls. And he be like, go get your pit bull, let's make a fight. That was hilarious. I give it to my guests on that one.
Now you see, he started this list, exactly. Right? And I want to show how sexist he is because I don't see not one set female. Of female comedians.
Listen, I like a bad man. Listen, yeah. I'm sorry.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
I want his fans to see how he beat against the
talk.
Women.
You can't even talk.
Point proven.
That's funny, because when he said that you came up with the game and stuff, you take credit. Now you're going to throw the credit back on me.
No,
that's that.
He started the list. No. The game.
Yeah, she ain't saying nothing
but
about that.
But the list was his. Okay.
Listen, I like Adele Gibbons.
Uh-huh. So she's how like, come you ain't matching up with nobody? Wanda
Sykes. I like Laura Hayes. Like, Laura Hayes came up with that great phase. And women should take this to the heat right now. FDS do not stand for the soap. Okay? It's a feminine spray. It's supposed to freshen you up, but it doesn't mean the soap.
It does not.
I'm just saying.
It does not.
That's it. But Adele Gibbons says, like, teeth crooked. I be going around like this. When I see a girl,
that's
she
not.
Got perfect teeth, I be like, you are not the one for me.
Oh,
you are not for me, baby.
He said, I need crooked. I need crooked.
No, 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 she is the
ridiculous.
Mama told me don't do those things.
Yo. I'm not even looking that way, man.
Yo, I got a question to ask you. So, I know you moving from, I'm not saying you giving up. I know you're not giving up the skits, but you're now transitioning into stand-up.
Yes, yes.
So, how was your first experience on stand-up?
My first experience. You talking about ever or just like a crowd where I don't know?
No, like a live audience, you're on stage, lights is on you, there a hush comes over the crowd, hush.
You know, yeah, it was not what I expected. I can tell you that.
So what happened?
This is actually a story I was telling earlier, actually. Like, I got on stage, like, I'm thinking, I'm about to kill it. Like, I'm feeling myself, you know, I'm looking at everybody like they less and I'm more. And like I started to tell a joke and they was not. Like, I've never told a joke and seen so many angry, they just look so disappointed. I could be doing something so much better. There was a white woman in the back and she was just whispering to her man, like, are you fucking kidding me? And she was looking at me, I'm like, sis, like, look, I didn't know it was gonna end up like this, man. It was just crazy. But I said one good joke, you know, they laughed, they got, you know, where I was coming from. And like, it was just, I got work. That's
see, this is my thing.
I got work.
I can't be a comedian. Because,
really?
Would you? I can't.
Seriously.
I'm dead serious.
People think it's easy.
It's not easy. Let me tell you why. I have a cousin who does comedy. And she goes, you should come up here and do it. You're hilarious. I said, no, I'm funny when people don't expect it.
My mom said the same thing.
So, when you pay, you got to realize, when you pay money to see somebody make you laugh, you want to be laughing.
That's true.
And they be sitting there like this. And I'm like, that ain't me. I'll be like, why did the chicken cross the road? Okay.
They're just looking at you like,
that's my time, guys. I gotta go.
I'm glad you gotta know when to bomb out.
Yeah.
You gotta pay
attention to the faces. Like, right. It's so key. Like, if you just bombing it, pay attention how they're looking at you like, I'm gonna fuck you up after the show because I did not pay all this money for you to do this to me like this, man. It's like, yo, that's what it is. Like, I look, at least I came up here and tried to make y'all laugh. Like, y'all can't do that. Like, yo.
Do you know how to, like, cater to your audience when you see
If I see it's not going good, I know how to bring it back to life. You feel me? Like, bring it back to life. You know, I can do that. That's what I can do.
When you do white jokes, do white people look like they're gonna get you?
No, they're actually like surprised and I know how to be one of them.
Okay, in here, let me see.
Yeah, I
can't.
Give me one.
I just came from the supermarket. I don't know if you guys are willing to eat, but I got some groceries in the back. You guys are hungry?
No, actually, I just ate like 3 to 4 minutes ago, so I don't think I'm hungry. How about you, Bob?
Yeah, but what happened?
No, you hungry? Dave is asking.
I'm good. I'm just playing a game. Just make sure you
Yo, that's exactly how they be. See, black people be on a whole nother level. You be like, yo, you hungry?
Yeah.
Yo, what you want? I'm about to order some Domino's.
I'm playing all three parts. Like, Bob wants to know. Oh, yeah,
I'm good.
I'm good.
I gotta finish it. Hold on. Just put on. Oh, God.
I put macaroni today. I threw on some macaroni, let it sit for like 5 to 10 minutes, and I think I'll be hungry then. Okay? All right, love you, bro.
No. They are the only people that can give you a time when you want it.
Make sure you set the clock. Set it. Seriously, because I don't like it too crispy, but not too crispy. Right in the middle. All right? Asshole, I love you. Go ahead.
And when they talk about macaroni, they talk about Velveeta. They not talking about that big macaroni. They talk about Velveeta and the shells.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I can't with y'all.
Yo, so what's next for you, like? Like,
oh man,
what do you want? Like, who do you want to work with in this industry?
You know what? Oh God, I would love, like, it would be my ultimate dream to work with Family Guy.
The Family Guy?
Yes, like that is so crazy. Like,
you know he's a cartoon, right?
I know. The person behind it. The person
did say that.
I say that.
No, the
he said I want to work with Family Guy.
No, silly. He's dumb. Look, I'm talking
about
why. Why he just giving me the white voice?
Silly. God, you guys don't get it. You're not into it like
he
that.
He's like two shades. No, black Asian ass.
He
is a
blackity. Yeah. No, I would love to work with Family Guy. I would love to work with Family
Guy. Okay.
I want to get.
You want to be a voiceover on Family Guy?
Something, man. Write skits.
What kind of character would you want to be on there?
I'm gonna throw
a black white person in there to see if they.
A black white person.
Yeah, he just like he my skin tone, but his voice just don't add.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody from Park Slope.
You know, yeah.
That's okay. Gotcha.
They already know.
The Park Slope dudes do that all the time.
Social media, how people keep up with
follow
you, follow
me,
you?
Of course, man. Y'all follow me on Instagram, Rah Da God, R-A-H-D-A. Let's mix that up. D-A-G-O-D. Facebook, Rah Da God, R-A-H-T-E. No? Because they looking at me like I'm losing it. I can't have people just staring at me.
That's what you should
exactly. T-H-E-G-O-D. Oh my God. Like, Shice is scaring me because he's from Brooklyn. I see the whole Brooklyn outfit.
Trying to rob you.
Exactly. And I'm in brown. Like, I'm looking at these people out here grilling me. I can't be doing this. Like, this man out here.
Yeah, I do have a question, though, before we go. Do you think people can learn to be funny, or does it have to be natural?
Oh, that is a good question. I personally feel like you gotta have it, or you gotta have some type of swagger with it. You gotta have something. Not it, you know, the whole package, but you gotta have something.
Gotta have something.
Something, whether it's a move, a word, you know, a face, it's gotta be something, man.
Is there a comedy school? Like,
I wouldn't be here right now.
Well, I say it teaches you how to be a comedian.
There is.
I think that falls into acting.
Right. You can be doing acting. But there are places like Brooklyn House of Comedy on Putnam and Bedford. They do a WCW, which is a Wednesday comedy workout, which is dope. That was it's real dope. It's run by Joanna Bradley. It's real dope. Okay.
Now y'all wanna call.
We got a caller at the end of the show. Hold on, let's see. Oh, they hung up.
Banged it on you.
My bad. That was called back.
Did you hang up? I think I seen you.
No, I was trying to get.
Are you sure? You old, so you don't know. Y'all don't really know how to work technology these days. Let's see if they call back.
Yeah, listen, asshole.
Look,
okay? We're not gonna do this, okay?
Look, I'm just saying, you don't know what you really don't know there.
I really don't. Look, and we all looking down.
Look,
like,
they call back. What I tell
okay,
you?
Okay, here we go, let's go. Green is go. What up, you on the air? Caller. Hello, caller. Okay.
They're hung up.
Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Call
them,
man.
Oh, see? Now you should be pressing.
Right. They got scared.
It's something wrong. It's something wrong.
All right, I'm putting it up here now if they call back. So, I just want to say, I enjoyed you today.
Oh, I enjoyed y'all.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I think I'm funnier than the young guy.
Oh, talent.
Maybe we should go joke for joke.
Believe in yourself. Thank you. Believe in yourself. I can only talk for myself, so go ahead.
Grace. I'm happy to have you.
I'm happy to be here.
Right?
Hey,
this is how we're going to put this. Look, this is how you put women on the spot. Like, if you want to know a real answer, you got to put them on the spot where they can't change their mind. You know, it has to be right here. So, Grace.
Yes, sir.
Is this a thing now? Are we here together?
Are you going to be faithful to me, Shice?
I ain't say all that.
Look, now you're the one that's messing up. It's not even wrong.
Thank you.
See,
he can't commit to me, but he wants me to commit to him.
Listen, ridiculous. I still got Boost Mobile.
He can put me on the spot, but I can't put him on the spot.
People with Boost Mobile have a problem with commitments. That's why they don't get a contract. Okay? I have a problem with that.
See, he have questions, but I can't have
exactly
questions.
Exactly. Right. You know, this is why you need
witnesses. I got a lot of work to do.
This is why you need witnesses.
I got a lot of, thank you. Thank you for being here, guys.
Sunday. Chris just not like answer my question, though.
No. I tried to answer and he just gave me some
bullshit. You throw a question back. That's the problem with black women. That's why we like white women. They don't ask
enough. Oh, he did not. Just go
there's no extra questions.
You better hold me back.
Exactly.
Listen.
You better hold me back.
They make cheese sandwiches. Same. And they tell, like, everything.
Yo, no,
and then I get an attitude. You clean.
Exactly.
The minute they're done with your ass.
No, right. White woman, in a situation, if you got to go to work, a white woman, she gonna be like, yo, get up. If you don't get up, she leaving the crib.
Exactly.
A black woman, get your ass up, nigga. She gonna start throwing shit. She gonna make sure you get up for work. Right or wrong.
But
exactly.
I don't want
no.
Sometimes I just wanna be left alone.
And then you're gonna be fired.
Exactly.
And she gonna be taking your ass. Tell her family.
She gonna leave,
my
fact. She gonna leave. The white woman leave.
I'm not
doing that.
Once she say you're not, don't have nothing for her.
Once you go white, you're always right.
Oh, my
I'm just saying.
Nah.
You already know.
Once they go black, they never go back.
Exactly.
That's where we at.
That's a lie.
I never heard of white.
No, once
right.
they go
that
black,
sound
once
right.
you go black,
white
they black. Always talk back.
No, we throw it back. And y'all
yeah.
like that.
Exactly.
And
I changed
y'all
my mind.
Coming back.
I changed my mind.
Don't get it twisted.
Nah, I'm going to be honest. I can't mess with a white woman.
Yeah, right.
I don't deal with pink nipples.
Pink nipples.
You on the air on Roger Radio, what's good?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Nicole.
Hi, Nicole. Who are you calling for?
How you doing, Nicole? Are you serious?
Nicole?
Honey.
Sugar dumpling.
Honey, come on.
Come on, speak.
Talk to me.
Okay. Gotta let you go. You ain't saying nothing.
Hold up. She going.
We got another caller. You're on the air, Roach Radio. Hello?
What is this?
I call is it? Because I couldn't hear your voice.
Yeah, Hello?
It's on.
I think it's a white person. That's
can
nice.
You hear them?
that's an activist right now.
That's a white person.
All right.
Turn that
radio off! So we get ready to get up out of here.
Yeah, man.
Okay, but I got a question. Before
okay, come on, let's go.
I just really... Really, actually, a listener, for both of you guys,
okay,
a listener sent it to me.
See,
and I was going to discuss
didn't even
it.
Say, she didn't ask my question. You know what I'm saying? We got 3 minutes left, and she
I'm
didn't ask
answer
my question.
Question. I want to answer mine, too. You know, you got to be loyal to me.
Of course.
All right, I'll be loyal to an extent.
You'll be loyal to me to an extent.
You know, don't worry. Nobody else will come on these airwaves.
It's all me.
All right?
It's all me.
Exactly.
Unless she drops it like it's hot.
Bye.
No, come on, here we go, come on.
She gotta know how to jump it better than Stallion.
Hello?
Hello?
What's up? What's your name?
My name is Jasmine.
Jasmine, oh God. What's up, what you want? Oh God, I think I know that. What's up?
I'm riding, you're making
it
on the radio.
Thank you, love. Oh, she just going showing love. Like,
hey,
so
Jasmine. Hello?
Yes?
Are you gonna give him some for making it on the radio?
Oh! Jasmine, look, we friends.
I'm just joking.
Jasmine, don't answer that.
Don't do that.
You gotta know.
Don't answer that.
You gotta know if this is groupie love or this is a commitment.
She's my friend, you know?
Yeah, I love
supporting.
Her.
Yeah.
So,
this is what a friend is.
Jasmine, do you
smash?
Think
he's
uh-huh, this
fresh,
is a friend.
Jasmine, do you think he's funny?
Yes. Oh my God, the other day I was sitting next to him and my bad, but I was high and I could not stop laughing.
Okay, so
it's my fault.
See, that's a bad thing. Here's the bad thing. See, she was high, so she thinks everything's funny.
Okay, you know what? Look, answer this question. Well, Jasmine, what happened the next day? Look, Jasmine, was you high the next day?
No, I wasn't. He still had me cracking up.
Thank you. Don't
that's
do that.
What I'm
talking
about, Jasmine.
Yeah, look.
At all.
Exactly.
That's what I'm talking about, Jasmine. Give him some love.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you for calling, Jasmine.
No problem. Love you,
Rob. Yo, much love, man.
Aww.
All right. So we get ready to get up out of here. So go ahead, Grace. I know you have something to say real quick.
I just wanted to know, when you know, men say that they lie to women that they love, and then there's men that say that they tell the truth when they love a woman. So I want to know, who does men love more, the woman that they lie to or the woman they tell the truth to?
The woman that they lie to.
The woman they tell the truth to.
Yeah, lie.
See?
I tell the truth. I'm like, listen, hold on. Let me sit down real quick. I'm like baby boy. I lie to the women that I lie to my woman because I love her. Don't want to hurt her feelings. I tell the truth to these bozos because it doesn't matter.
He doesn't care.
Oh, I see where you're coming.
Thank
but
you.
But how do you see it?
Okay, well, it depends on the situation, obviously. But I, if I care about her and I really don't want this to twist and turn, I'm gonna tell the truth to her. He thought I said I was gonna lie to her. I'm gonna tell the truth to her just only because I care about
you.
Her.
Thank you.
And on that
that's note, showing real
exactly.
love.
Exactly. And I guess that falls into the young generation.
I got a lot of work to do with Shice.
Exactly.
I got a lot of work to do.
Exactly.
Well, we want to thank everybody. We want to thank Rah Da God for coming in today. And oh, we got
thank
that.
Y'all, man.
My new co-host, Grace The Stallion.
Watch that stallion.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
See, why does that sound sexual?
That's my slogan. Hey everybody, Grace the Stallion here, and I want you guys to talk it out with me every Saturday from 2 to 4 p.m. on We Got That Radio, hosted by Shice the Voice and me, Grace the Stallion. So download those Raw Truth Radio apps and let's watch that stallion.
If it's music, you know we got that. Interviews with who, where who, you know we got that. About fashion, hey, you know we got that. The video just dropping, hey, you know we got that. Hey, hey, you know we got that. Shice the Voice of Brooklyn, you know we got that. Hey, you know we got that. Anything you wanna see, baby, we got it.